These so-called racial realists continue to assert that there's a scientific basis for petty bigotry and discrimination, and in fact, that the different races should be sorted by continents. All the black people in Africa, all the Native Americans in America, all of the whites in Europe, all of the Asians in Asia, all of the Indians in India, and so on and so on and so on and so on. Evogen Videos has already done a far, far, far superior job to what I could ever do in refuting their claims regarding genetics and race. What I plan to do is debunk their pseudoscience on a deeper level. When they launched Voyager 1, they programmed it ahead of time with every single picture it would take. Not the picture itself, but when and where to take it. And when they did something brilliant. They programmed it, when it finally left the solar system, to turn around and take a snapshot of the Earth as it would be seen from space. Where are the continental boundaries? Where are all of the different races? Where are the differences that are deemed so large? Where is the justification for petty bigotry, for discrimination, for denial of the reality of our equality? Where are the national boundaries that nationalists such as yourselves cling to? Where is the inequality for which you argue? Where is our ability to afford dividing ourselves when at any moment a hostile enemy could arise that we can only survive by uniting, at least temporarily, as a single species, which is what we are? Where is that significance of the petty, small differences between human beings? How foolish our petty bigotry must truly look to something that sees the Earth as it really is, as a small, pale blue dot with an inhabitant that cannot afford to waste its time with infighting over differences such as race, religious creed, place of birth, political opinions. We are a single species, and I sincerely hope that that realization will come to humanity before it is too late.